Well, good Thursday morning, everyone. Thank you for tuning in to Inspiration for Today. I think it's going to be that for you, an inspiration for today. If it's not, I can't do any better than the verse that we're going to come to right now. It's one of the most quoted verses in all the Bible. But here's the thing. I'm so excited for you and me because we are studying it in the context of which it is written. And that is so important in understanding. That's true of all verses. And so many times we take memory, quote unquote, memory verses out of context. Why were they written? No one just wrote a verse down, unless you're thinking of David in Psalms and Solomon in Proverbs. But in general, verses were written in the form, in the context of a broader picture. And that's certainly the case here. Let me first give you the verse. It's in Philippians chapter 1 at verse 6. That's where we come to. And we went through verse 5 yesterday. Verse 6. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Now, since we know the context, we know that he's saying it to who? The church at Philippi, the Philippians. And who's the he who began? He's talking about the Lord, the Lord. Now, remember, this is in the midst of just his opening greetings and encouragement of the letter that he wrote from the Roman prison. And he's writing it to people that he called what yesterday? Partners. Partnership in the gospel. He loves these people. They're partners with him. They're partners in financially supporting his ministry. He wants to say some of the most encouraging truths that he can think of. In this case, he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion. What does that mean, completion? Well, he's talking about what the Christian life is all about. And that is that God wants to grow us to maturity, to be more and more like Christ. We'll never make it in this life, but he keeps working in our lives. So we shouldn't get too discouraged, or we shouldn't get any discouraged when we do something that we're not pleased with. Because God isn't finished with us. He's still working in our lives. Sometimes he works through pain. Sometimes he works through insights into Scripture. That's far better, isn't it? And I'm glad that we're studying this great book together. He's going to use it in our lives to help mature us as we go. But this is just such a verse that you really should memorize. Remember where it's from, Philippians 1:6. He's writing to people whom he loves. And then he says, I love when we read it in context. Because, well, let's just keep reading. Verse 7. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart. For whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel, all of you share in God's grace with me. God can testify how I long for all of you in the affection of Christ Jesus. So he's actually expanding, isn't he, on that word partnership, that they share in God's grace with him. So that partnership includes sharing God's grace. But this next paragraph actually goes back to carrying on that good work in you to completion. To completion. So verse 9 and through 11, it's actually in Paul's prayer, he's praying for their maturity. And I just use it as a definition of what completion means. We can sure use this in our life too. Here's what we ought to be shooting for, striving for, studying for, praying for. Verse 9. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless until the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. Wow. That's what we're striving for. That our love may abound. And not just haphazard feeling emotional love, but more and more in knowledge and depth of insight. How to love even better. And this book is a part of that, because he actually, much of the, what comes, the rest of the book is going to help us do these things. To grow in knowledge and depth of insight. Why? So that we'll be able to discern what is best and pure and blameless. That's how Paul wants his Philippian brothers and sisters to live. If Paul were writing this to us in Laguna Woods, it'd be the same. That we could discern what is best and may be pure and blameless until the day of Christ. That's what he wanted for them. That's what we ought to want for ourselves and for our brothers and sisters in Christ. And I think we do. I honestly think we do. We want to grow in love. I learned so much from being around our church family. So many of you, I see more love demonstrated than I have in my life. And I'm in awe and thankful to the God that I'm learning from you. I absolutely am. And I thank you for the lives that you are living in Christ. They're meaningful. I just think this is wonderful. And then he says it twice. Well, in our verse for the day, he says, that you'll carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. And right at the end of this one, he says, until the day of Christ. What does he mean by that? Well, the day of Christ really means, in general for the church, the day when he comes back for his church. We often call that day the rapture. When in 1 Thessalonians 4, if you want to read about it, when Jesus comes back for his beloved family, the church, that's the day of Christ. And we're taken out of this earth and we'll be with him. Now, for those that are alive and die prior to that, our day of Christ is when he meets us, when we go to be with him in heaven. And that will be a wonderful day for us. And then we would be with him until he comes back down. And we would come with him for that too. It's, God has a great thing. But anyway, God's going to keep growing and maturing you and me until we meet Jesus one way or the other. Well, God bless. So much to think about today. But we're going to just hold on to all of it, that God is not through with us yet. He began a good work in us, and he's going to carry it on. Hey, God bless, and we'll spend a little more time in the Bible together tomorrow. See you then. Bye for now.